It is now my great pleasure to introduce Sandor Lehoczky, with whom I've had the immense privilege of working with for several years at Jane Street. Sandor is a senior leader at Jane Street who has promoted math education, competitions, and access for more than three decades, a mentorship and education that personally I've benefited tremendously from. For the audience here, Sandor is perhaps most well-known to y'all for writing and self-publishing the seminal two-volume series of books, The Art of Problem Solving, in 1994 with Richard Resick, and for having founded the Mandelbrot competition with Sam Vanderveld and Richard in 1990. I still have copies of both books at home from my Math Prize for Girls days, and I'm fairly sure that many of you all have benefited tremendously from these and other Art of Problem Solving book materials. Sandor graduated from Princeton University with academic honors in 1994 with a bachelor's in physics and a certificate in applied math. He spent 2 years as a trader on the floor of the Chicago Board Options Exchange before joining Jane Street in 2001. Since then, he's led a variety of operations and firm-wide initiatives, including architecting the firm's equity desk, co-founding the Quantitative Research Group, expanding recruitment efforts, and undertaking foundational work in developing the firm's risk philosophy. In the mid-2000s, Sandor co-founded the Art of Problem Solving Initiative, a nonprofit focused on bringing powerful resources to high-achieving students who have encountered barriers to success in mathematics. AOPSI's signature program, the Bridge to Entering Advanced Mathematics, or BEAM, serves talented students across the country, starting with summer enrichment programs in sixth and seventh grade, and continuing with support through high school and into college. Please give a warm welcome to Sandor Lehoczky.
So I have a prop, and the prop is my shirt, so I need to stand here. Has anybody here ever read and enjoyed any examples of speculative fiction involving magic, like Harry Potter or Lord of the Rings or any other things like that? Give me, how about a round of a clap or something, just so we can hear that. People love magic. People love this idea of a mysterious, interconnected network that certain sophisticated people can tap into the power of and go deep into, be able to channel it into effects in the world. For my birthday at work, some people put together this shirt that I'm wearing, and it's got this beautiful little sort of spirograph thing on the front with some connected lines, and most people would see that and say, like, oh, it's just a nice little thing with a bunch of connected lines. But this being Jane Street, of course, anytime you see something like that, you know there's a deeper meaning. The room is so big, I was actually going at this point to see if anybody happened to know what it was, which would be very impressive. This is a thing called the Hoffman-Singleton graph. It's a special graph with 50 points around the outside of the circle, and there's very cool things going on in the graph. I'm sure Nithya could stand on one foot and give a lecture about it. And it's pretty amazing, and the thing is, as you start to dig into it, you start to realize how it ties into this incredibly broad field of math called graph theory, which some of you have probably learned something about, and many expansive areas of math, including some of the things that are going to, I think, to be touched on in the keynote speech today, so I'm very much looking forward to that. The one thing that I couldn't quite figure out is why it was given to me for my 35th birthday, so I couldn't quite tie all of that together, because it's got the 50 points on it. So that didn't exactly resonate. So here's the thing. There is magic in this world. We don't need to go read fiction to get magic, and math is magic. As you learn to think as a mathematical thinker, you're going to look around, and you start to see mathematical patterns in everything you look at. And you start to realize that everything is tied together by these powerful mathematical threads. And you're seeing the world in a way that very, very few people can. Just as a wizard or witch, I guess they say in Harry Potter, which doesn't sound as good, goes around seeing magical threads interconnecting beings and spirits and things like that. Math is the magical threads that you will learn to see and are learning to see and have learned to see that nobody else can see. And that's when you go on to college, and some of you to advanced education in math or advanced work in areas where you're using math, that's what you're going to realize as you're moving further and further into networks of people that are also interested in that can also see those threads, that can also make those connections. Because the other unbelievably important network, in addition to the network of mathematical relationships that governs all of the things that we're seeing and everything that's going on, is the relationship among all of you. When Arun and the Advantage Testing Foundation came to Jane Street with the offer to form a partnership and endow the prize for the long term, it was just an immediate magical fit, you know, for the amount of money involved. I think the amount of negotiation was by far the least I would have possibly imagined, because in addition to the power of the mathematical education you're all having, the power of the network that you're all forming, and being able to have this enormous group, not just of current Math Prize participants, but past Math Prize participants, future Math Prize participants, this network of people that you form is going to generate incredible power as you go forward in the world. And I hope that you'll seek to help others as they come along in the path, just as people have helped you to get to this point. I want to thank Arun for bringing Jane Street into this partnership. We are incredibly grateful to be a part of this. I want to thank MIT. This is an unbelievable facility. And I want to get off the stage because I'm really excited to hear from Dr. I had the pronunciation before, Dr. Oz from MIT, and the talk about neural nets. So thank you very much. Really appreciate it.